somebody will say, this is just Joseph's son. So Jesus will do it. But when Mary said, what's here, he says to you, do it. You see, what Mary recognizes is that he is the written word. He is the spoken word. And he is the living word. And so Mary understood that the living word was standing in your midst. And you got to understand that anyway Jesus is, something got to happen. At least somebody would understand that Jesus is in the house. And if he's in the house, then something is about to happen. God, let's look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, get ready, because something is about to happen. God, Mary says, whatever he says to do, just do it. Why? Because the words that you speak, they are spirit, and they are life. And so anytime he opens his mouth and speaks, something has got to happen. As God spoke a word in your spirit, then something has got to happen. And so Mary said, whatever he says to do, just do it. The problem that we face is that anytime the Lord speaks to us, we try to figure out what he is saying. He didn't say try to figure it out, but whatever he says to do, just do it. Sometimes it looks stupid, but if he said it, just do it. I examined the text, and I recognized that Jesus didn't have a spoon. He didn't have any ingredients that he was carrying around to make any wine. But Jesus said to them, I want you to pour the water in the pot. And he didn't touch the water. But somewhere between the pouring of the water and reaching the pot, he turned into wine. I wonder what I'm preaching to tonight. Has the Lord given you a word? If the Lord said jump, somewhere between leaving the ground and reaching the ground, your body will be healed. Your sorrow will turn into joy. Whatever it says to do, whatever it says to do, just do it. I recognize that this name, it carries power. I recognize that it carries authority. Why do I say that? Because he was not just Jesus, but he was the anointed one. The Bible says that he was a man that was called Abraham, and he was childless. My God, but the Lord gave him a word and said, hey man, your wife Sarah shall bring forth a son. Our God, and at the appointed time, she gave birth. Something about the name his power. I heard when the Apostle Paul said, as many of us as were baptized into Jesus, but not just Jesus, into Jesus Christ. So when you're going down, you put on the name, but not just the name, you take on the anointing. Somebody, you need to understand that you've got power. That's why the devil is attacking you. That's why you have the pressure, but you got something that the devil is afraid of. Father, let me show you something. Is I am carrying a gift. I am the carrier of the gift. You need to understand that you're carrying the anointing. And so the devil can't touch the anointing. So he's coming after your body. Because I'm a shatter. Because you are the carrier. That's why you have the pressure. Because you are the carrier. But I shall not die. Never. I'm going to live. I'm going to live. So neighbor, don't think it's strange why you're under pressure. The day you lose your anointing, all your trouble is over. But as long as you carry the anointing, as long as you carry Christ, you'll never be under pressure. Because you carry power. Power. Somebody said power. So because I'm walking with the name, the devil don't know who I am. Because I dress ordinary. I look ordinary. So he don't know who I am. But have you ever been in a situation where you're walking on the road, you weren't worshiping and you weren't doing anything, but all of a sudden the anointing comes upon you? What I'm trying to say to you is that the anointing becomes a watchdog. So some things you cannot see, but before you see it, the anointing together, you can't come back up, you can't back. Oh, God, help me. The way you can't come back up, your father was ordinary. From here to my walk, through the valley, like the shadow of death, I'm not gonna feel it. What is in me? Just touch yourself. I say, Lord, pour your anointing. Out of the summer. Pour it. Pour it. Pour it. Is there somebody that is ready for the first anointing?